Microsoft just announced a $17.5 billion investment in AI in India. Guys, Microsoft is going all in on AI, and they believe that India is one of the best places in the world to build this infrastructure. But look, don't just take my word for it. Listen to what the CEO, Satya Nadella, says. He says, quote, building on the $3 billion investment announced in January of 2025, our new $17.5 billion commitment and deep partnership across India's technology ecosystem are focused on turning India's AI ambition into impact for every citizen. And he continues, this transformation is anchored on three pillars: hyperscale infrastructure to run AI at scale, sovereign-ready solutions that ensure trust, and skilling programs that empower every Indian to not just join the future, but shape it. Guys, this four-year plan starts in 2026 and would give Microsoft the largest cloud computing presence in India. But why India? Well, we'll get there in just a moment. In the meantime, I'm Mark. I bring you a fresh video on AI and the job infrastructure 6 days a week. Make sure that you subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on what's next, because the world is changing very fast. I want you to remain relevant, respected, and financially free. All right, let's get into it. Why India? Why is India where Microsoft is really, really doubling and tripling down on? Well, in India, there's over 1 billion users with a deep technical talent. Plus, they work for a lot less than your average US citizen. I'll give you an example here. The average software engineer in India is gonna make about 15 to 35K a year. If you were to go to the US and hire, that's gonna cost you 110 to 170K. That is a huge increase in the cost of talent. I mean, you're almost 10X the cost of talent here in the US and versus India. And by the way, I've worked with a bunch of Indians on projects before, and quite frankly, they're great. We'll get to some of the competitive advantages that Americans have in just a moment. Hold that thought. But again, I've worked with people all over the world, from India to South America to Serbia to the Philippines, Pakistan, Bangladesh. I mean, I've worked with people all over the world, and I will say, they get a lot done for your dollar, and that's why a lot of companies do outsource and offshore. However, there are, again, some advantages that Americans have. I'll get to that in a moment. Again, as someone who's worked with dozens and dozens of offshore workers, I can give you some of the weaknesses. Again, we'll get there in just a moment. Regardless, Indian workers are going to be way cheaper than Americans, which makes India a prime place for building these data centers. In addition to that, Microsoft doubled its pledge to equip 20 million Indians with AI skills by 2030. So not only are they doubling, tripling, quadrupling down on the data center and AI cloud infrastructure, but they're also doubling down on training Indian workers. You know, in addition to that, you've got lower construction labor costs, you've got reduced staffing costs, and you have a strong fiber architecture. There's already a good amount of infrastructure. However, there are some weaknesses there, and hold that thought, we'll get there in just a moment. One of the other advantages to India is there's gonna be less resistance to data center construction. Just this year, guys, there were several US data centers planned. There was a data center in Wisconsin planned, Ohio planned. They got blocked because the communities don't want these huge, large, black humming boxes in their backyard soaking up all of the energy. Well, you go to India, they're gonna be more receptive to it. Not 100% receptive, but it's gonna be an easier sell than the United States. By the way, I recorded an entire video on what's happening with data centers getting blocked. Go check out that video here. I think you'll be very interested in more details on what's happening with data centers and them getting blocked. Because please believe, Microsoft is not the only company that's getting these data centers built and having them blocked. You've got Meta, you've got Amazon, Google, all these companies are building these huge AI data centers, and quite frankly, most communities don't want them in their backyard, costing these companies hundreds of millions of dollars. Again, go check out that video here. But look, there are more challenges to data center infrastructure in addition to what we've already mentioned. And Satya, on a podcast recently, mentioned that reliable power is a big problem. He says, and I quote, "The biggest issue we are having is not computer glut, not compute glut, but it's power. It's sort of the ability to get the builds done fast enough to close the power. It's not a supply issue of chips. It's the fact that we don't have enough warm shells to plug into." Guys, this is the big problem these companies have right now. You can build, they have the chips, They have these data centers being built, but they don't have the power to run them. And by the way, you look at Moore's Law, these chips, this technology has become more efficient, more powerful, and it's gonna cost a lot less over time. This stuff just happens over time. It's gonna cost, you're gonna be able to get a lot more compute done for a lot less money. That is definitely happening. Another side note, and I'm preparing a video for this, a lot of these data centers now, well, are not gonna be actually built on planet Earth, but up in space, and there's a lot of advantages to building in space. I kind of touched on this in yesterday's video, but you know, when you're building in space, your solar power is gonna be much more powerful. It's 24/7, it's much cheaper to compute. You've got vacuums in space, which allow data transfers and networking at a cheaper rate. You don't have to worry about fiber lines, you can just have lasers. Anyway, we'll get into that in another video. Regardless, what Satya is saying here is that we can build the data centers, but we need the power and the energy. And that brings me to my second point. Solar power is not going away. Sure, I had some guys who were selling a ton of solar panels and they were getting these big government subsidies and they were selling a ton of solar panels. Well, maybe that's gone, but solar power is not gone. Even Elon Musk is talking about the power of solar. But nuclear is also a huge deal. And in India, they're much more receptive to nuclear. In fact, India aims to quadruple its nuclear capacity by 2047. And you tell someone in the United States, hey, we're gonna be building a nuclear power facility near your city. Nobody is up for that. Nobody. I guarantee you, you went onto the street and you asked 100 people if they wanted a nuclear power plant in their backyard, you would get a 100% hell no ranking there. In India, they're still not gonna be totally receptive, but they are gonna be much more receptive to these power. And plus, they're not gonna have the same type of voting power as it comes. There's not quite as much power. It kind of reminds me of a book that I'm reading, and shout out to Mr. Henry the Great, you'll see him in the comments. But he took me off to this book called Confessions of an Economic Hitman. And essentially what the book is about is powerful American companies, and he also talks about China, but powerful companies from first world countries going in to developing countries and essentially building out tons of infrastructure and straddling them with debt to build it. Regardless, I don't know what the exact correlation here is between Microsoft building these data centers. However, there are some echoes between what's happening now with infrastructure being built around the world. Okay, so A, we talked about the challenge of power. You gotta have more power. India's gonna give you better access, but there's also a challenge with water and cooling. You gotta cool these data centers. They get hot, the GPUs get really, really hot. You gotta cool them. And having access to water can be a challenge, especially when you're competing against local drinking and agricultural needs. You know, if you're a farmer, if you're a regular person in India or in the United States, you might say, hey, you know, I need that water. I need that energy. It's important for me. I live off of that. We don't want it being soaked up by these large AI data centers. The other challenge for developing the AI in India is the talent gap. Is there enough talent to actually build, construct, man, develop these data centers? Well, again, we mentioned this earlier in the video, Microsoft is planning to upskill 20 million Indian workers. That is happening. Guys, that's happening. That's happening, okay? But here's the kicker, guys. It doesn't just end in India. I was speaking to a friend of mine who is in the data center business at Microsoft. He works for Microsoft and data centers. And he explained to me that Microsoft is planning to build 1,000 data centers, 1,000 data centers now globally. Now, when I go to their Microsoft's website, they claim that they're doing 400, they have plans for 400 plus data centers. I got it. I got the inside track, guys. This is why you subscribe to the channel. I got the inside track that it's actually closer to 1,000. Regardless, Microsoft is investing $80 billion in data centers just this year. In fact, they spent over $11.1 billion just on leases for data centers for fiscal year 2026 quarter Q1. So long story short, the data centers don't just end in India. It just so happens that India is a prime prospect for data center construction, like I had mentioned. Now, listen. I mean, I'm giving big numbers. all over the place, global ideas. What does this mean for me and you? What does this mean for regular guys like you and me who just want to feed our family, we want to live good lives, we want to be financially free, we want to raise awesome, killer kids? What does this mean for guys like you and me? Well, here's the deal, guys. This AI investment infrastructure, at this point, I can officially say it's too big to fail. It is not going to stop, guys. And quick side note, that might not necessarily be a bad thing because, quite frankly, I think you could argue that without the tech and AI infrastructure that's happening, we'd pretty much be in a recession. You might argue we're already in a recession. That's fine. I mean, we pumped trillions of dollars into the economy. COVID crushed us. All our kids are retarded now because they took time off of school and they're behind. Our literacy rates are down. I digress. It's not all doom and gloom. What I will say, though, is that this AI infrastructure is not going to stop. It's happening. You can't boycott your way out of AI. One of the comments I see in here is people saying like, oh, well, I won't shop at company X because they laid off people for AI. And listen, that's fine. That's your prerogative. But that's not going to stop. That's not going to stop the tsunami that is AI. It is too big. And here's what that means. It means that AI literacy is mandatory. It is table stakes. You will not be able to function in the business world without AI literacy. It is mandatory. Now you might say, well, I want to go into the trades. I want to go into farming. Guys, everything is going to be impacted by AI, automation, and robotics. It just is. So you can't just, you know, stick your head in the dirt and wait for it to pass. AI is here. It is coming. You got to learn how to use these tools. And if you want to build up your skills, you can subscribe to my newsletter at aiupdate.ai. It's completely free. I'm not selling anything, but you go to aiupdate.ai. And you know, there's various learning materials. I send out a weekly newsletter with prompts and trainings and some of the software that I'm enjoying right now, helping me build my skills and my businesses. But regardless, AI literacy is table stakes. You gotta have it. You're not gonna be able to function. It's kind of like saying, oh, I wanna work, but I don't wanna use computers. Okay, well, you're kind of limiting your ability to grow. I was reading an article the other day and it was something around 90% of jobs that make over $100,000 a year require AI literacy at this point. I don't remember the exact stat. Don't quote me on that. Regardless, the point is the AI literacy is mandatory. If you wanna function, if you wanna grow, if you wanna support your family, you're gonna need to have AI literacy. But I wanna kind of circle back to this point at the beginning. Okay, Mark, what do? I can't compete against these Indian workers. They're smart, they're motivated, they're hungry. And they're willing to work for a fraction of what I need to supply and feed my family here in the United States. Well, here's one thing I've noticed about Indian workers over time. And this isn't a knock on Indian workers. I know we've got a large viewership of Indians out there. What's up, guys? I appreciate you being here. But this is an advantage that Americans have over Indians. And there's a few things. The first of which is cultural context. You know, there's certain types of things that, you know, we say here in the United States that aren't really repeated in India. It's just different. We watched, you know, we have a different history. And, you know, by understanding the context of speaking, by understanding sports, athletics, and different cultural phenomenons, historical figures, it gives you maybe not necessarily an advantage, but it allows you to communicate better. And I think that is the big thing, guys, is that when I communicate with people in the United States versus people in India, the communication just feels easier. It feels more seamless. And again, this isn't a knock on you guys. You can always improve. But this is a competitive advantage, is the relationships and the communication, the ability to lead. These are going to be really, really valuable skills, guys, over the coming years. So leverage the relationships. Make sure that you have AI literacy as part of your game plan. It's mandatory. You must be using AI. You must be finding new ways to use AI. I will not take on a project now if it doesn't give me the opportunity to test and use new AI and have money allocated towards AI budget. I just won't do it. It's just not, it doesn't make sense to me. I want to be on the cutting edge. So should you. That's important. So be on the cutting edge, leverage your relationships, make sure that you're communicating, you're leveraging the context, your understanding of United States culture. That is going to be your main competitive advantage. You're not going to be able to compete. Another thing, one of the things that I've noted here, and this is not necessarily an Indian problem, or a differentiator, but you know, the time with which you communicate with others is really, really important. There have been some people I've worked with in the past that don't put value on speed to respond. I'm just one of the guys I'm working with this week. I sent a message, one of the team members on this team, sent a message on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, finally got a response here on Thursday, and it was very brief, like, okay, I'll look at it. You're not gonna be able to remain an employee if you're if you're responding to messages 5 or 6 days later. You're just not gonna, it's not gonna work for you. So make sure you're communicating quickly, make sure you're hitting your deadlines, make sure you're tracking your KPIs. I mean, I should maybe record an entire episode on the things that I look for when looking at team members and teams and projects to take on. But what I will say is this, you have intrinsic, regardless of where you're from, you're a human being, you have tons of value. I value you. I appreciate you being here on the channel. And don't sleep on AI, guys. It is happening. India is going to be a huge hub for AI investment and infrastructure, and it's not going to stop. It is not going to stop, guys. It's going to continue. So don't disregard it. All right, guys, I appreciate you watching today's video. Thanks for liking and subscribing. If you enjoyed this video, you'll definitely be interested in yesterday's video. I'll put a hot link to it here. Go check it out. You'll enjoy it. You'll be more educated, and you'll be ready for what is coming next. All right, boys, I'll see you there. Peace.